Hello, I am Dr. Rahish Ravindran. I am a clinical immunologist and rheumatologist practicing rheumatology since last 10 years. I am attached to Jupiter Hospital, Bethany Hospital, and I have my own clinic at Ramaruthi Road. I would like to thank Mr. K. Kumar and the PTRA for allowing me to interact with you all and discuss something about rheumatology. So first of all, we will start with who is a rheumatologist. So there is always a confusion regarding orthopedician and a rheumatologist, whom to go for joint complaints. So orthopedicians and rheumatologists are two different specialists. So both of us deal with joints, but orthopedicians deal more with the surgical aspect of it, and we deal with more of the medical aspect of it. So how does a rheumatologist study? Like, he does his MBBS, then he does his 3 years of postgraduate, that is MD medicine or DNB medicine. Then after that, he trains again for 3 more years in rheumatology and immunology. What are rheumatic diseases? Everybody has an immune system. So the job of the immune system is to protect our body from outside invasion, from bacteria, fungus, viruses. So what happens in some individuals is a certain part of this immune system, some cells of this immune system, suddenly starts behaving abnormally. Instead of protecting ourselves, it starts attacking our own body or attacking our own cells. So in this process, these cells can damage our joints, our internal organs like kidneys, lungs, brain, liver, skin. So all these manifestations can happen once the patient has rheumatic disease, or what we commonly called as autoimmune diseases. Now, what are the types of rheumatic diseases? There are almost 100 different types of rheumatic diseases, or autoimmune disease as we call it. But the three common diseases that we see are rheumatoid arthritis, spondyloarthritis, and lupus. So rheumatoid arthritis is a disease which affects the small joints and the large joints. It usually is seen more in females as compared to males. Females with rheumatoid arthritis would complain of small joint pain and swelling with early morning stiffness. They would specifically complain that the pain increases with rest and improves with activity. That means the patient with rheumatoid arthritis would like to continue working rather than resting. So if the patient rests for some time, the pain increases. Rheumatoid arthritis is usually limited to the joints and very rarely can affect the internal organs, example the lungs, skin, or the nerves. The second commonest arthritis that we see is spondyloarthritis. The word spondylo means spine. So this kind of arthritis affects the spine. So most of the patients in this group are males as compared to females. They usually come to us with persistent low backache, early morning pain and stiffness, pain and swelling over the large joints, severe heel pain. So these are the common complaints that a patient with spondyloarthritis would come to us. Sometimes spondyloarthritis can affect other organs like the eyes, the skin, the bowels, and the heart also. The other common disease is the third one is lupus. Lupus again is a very female dominant disease. So most of the patients who come to us are females. This disease is different as compared to rheumatoid arthritis and spondyloarthritis. So in this disease, in addition to the joints, that means the small joint pain, swelling, and all those things, patients have dominant other systemic features like skin rashes, hair loss, oral ulcers, eye pain and redness, skin allergies. They can have kidney problems, they can have lung issues, they can have seizures. So it's this lupus affects not only the joints, it affects entire body. So all the major organs can get affected in a patient with lupus. There are many other diseases, but these are the three common diseases that we see in our OPD practice. Now coming to the age group. So there is always a misconception that arthritis happens only in elderly patients, but that is not the case. So the disease that we deal with, the arthritis that we deal with, can happen from as young as 6-year-old boy to a 60-year-old gentleman. So it has no age limit. It can happen any time during your life and in any severity, in any combination that can happen to an individual. So age group is not a factor. Majority of the autoimmune diseases or rheumatic diseases are female dominant. As we discussed, that there are some diseases which are male dominant, but majority of the diseases are more in females. Now coming to what are the common symptoms of rheumatic diseases. So initially the patients would complain of small joint pain and swelling and early morning stiffness. So usually the arthritis complaints are worse with rest and improves with activity. Generally we hear that, you know, in a common man that, you know, after a day's work the back hurts and then you go back to, you know, go and take rest and it improves. But in rheumatic diseases is exactly the opposite. So the patient takes rest and the pain worsens, and the patient is active, the pain subsides or patient becomes better. So this is a very important difference that one should notice to suspect rheumatic diseases. Other common complaints are usually backache. As I discussed with joints, this kind of backache persists or worsens after prolonged rest and improves with activity. So the patient would like to keep on moving around, be active rather than sitting or sleeping, because he's afraid that if he sits or sleeps for a long time, the back pain worsens. Especially in spondyloarthritis, early morning pain and stiffness is very, very common. The other some symptoms that you should be looking out for, along with the arthritis, if you have recurrent fevers, if you have hair loss, if you have eye redness, if you have mouth ulcers, if you have skin rashes, if you have breathlessness, if you have swelling over the lower limbs at the end of the day, your recurrent headaches, these are also other common symptoms of rheumatological diseases. So if you have any of the above complaints or above symptoms, you should immediately consult your rheumatologist. There are many treatments available for rheumatological diseases, although it cannot be cured because it is an autoimmune disease. It is immunity related disease, so you cannot cure it. It is like diabetes or blood pressure. You cannot cure it, but you can get very good control with the kind of medication that are available. So the majority of the treatment depends on two kinds of drugs, what we call as DMARDs or biological therapy. DMARDs are usually tablets and biological therapies are injectables, which are the latest treatments for rheumatological diseases or autoimmune diseases. Initially, your doctor may give you some low-dose steroids or painkillers. So you should not get worried about that your doctor suddenly started steroids. So steroids are usually given for a very short course, not more than 6 to 12 weeks, and the patient is just continued on arthritic medications. So steroids and painkillers are not given for a long time. Yes, initially for a few weeks the doctor may give you that, so you don't have to worry. So make sure that if you have any of these complaints, so please visit your rheumatologist and discuss with your rheumatologist regarding all your complaints, and then he will ask you for some tests which will determine what kind of rheumatological disease that you have, and accordingly the doctor can take care of you and start you on therapy.